Everybody wants to have a happy family, but arguments, hurt feelings, and even exhaustion can make home a hard place to live. Psychologist Dr. Kevin Leman believes that any family can find and maintain happiness. He says all it takes is better communication, respect, and a little teamwork. In his new book, Have a Happy Family by Friday, Dr. Leman says you can learn to do that in just 5 days.
Welcome to 700 Club Interactive, the author of Have a Happy Family by Friday, Dr. Kevin Leman. It's great to have you with us today.
Thank you, Terry.
Talk a little bit about having, you say we can have a new family in just 5 days. How so? How does that work?
Well, you can do it quicker than that, actually. I mean, it doesn't take long. You're the parent, okay? I call it parental poker. Some people don't like that term, but quite frankly, your kid wouldn't have underwear on if you didn't buy it for him.
That is okay? True.
So you really are in authority over your children. And if things are not well in your family, this is a great book because it sort of studies the sheep. The sheep. That's an interesting slip of the tongue.
That works too.
Yeah, it does. because they are like sheep. And you got to be a good shepherd.
Yeah.
And you can't be just rule-based. But one of the main points of this book, Terry, is this. The words you choose to use with your kids changes everything. A kid gets in the car. You're driving to school. And she puts in her CD. I'm here to tell you, as a parent, you're not going to like the music.
Yeah.
Want to do something different? Say, honey, turn that up. What? Turn that up, honey. And she turns it up a little bit. Say, louder. And then start bumping around, you know. And, I mean, find some common ground with these kids. Because if you don't, they're going to systematically shut you out of their life. And you're not going to have that chance to put that indelible imprint on that kid's life.
And if you don't express interest in the things that interest them, in a way, you're shutting yourself out. I mean, you're doing it with your own inaction as well as action.
We do it so naturally. Yeah. We grill kids. Kids come home from school, okay? And what do parents say? Honey, how was your dance going?
Mm-hmm.
Fine. What'd you do in school today? Nothing. Teenager, where you been? Out. What'd you do? Nothing. Save your wind. And parents say, if I don't ask a question, I'm never going to learn anything about my kid. That is so wrong. Just sit there. They'll say something and then say something like, interesting. Tell me more about that. And tell me more about that, although it's a command, doesn't put the defenses up. And as a sidebar for all you women, okay, us men hate questions, and we hate the why word. You want a happy marriage? Stop asking us why, okay? We specialize in arm's length relationships. We're much different than you talkative, caressing, wonderful women.
What are the most common pitfalls that people make? Husband or wife, parents?
Well, I think it's when you have those, what do you call them, children.
Yeah.
That's one of those pitfalls. But I think the biggest thing that I see today from where I sit is we bring up kids with a sense of entitlement.
Yeah.
We bring them to feel like they're the center of the universe. And again, if you're a person of faith, where's the room for Almighty God if you do that?
Yeah.
I think we give kids too many things. We don't challenge kids enough. Kids don't give back to the family.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's important that kids work. And so if the 12-year-old doesn't clean his room without warning, this is the fun part. It's fun to blindside kids. Hire his 10-year-old sister, who he doesn't particularly like, to clean his room for him, but pay for it out of 12-year-old's allowance.
Ooh.
And so what I'm asking parents to do and have a happy family by Friday is just stand up and be the parent.
Mm-hmm.
You're either the co-captain or the captain of the ship.
But one of the things you do so well in the book is you show us how to do that without belligerence, without anger, without any kind of judging expression in your voice.
Right.
You do it with authority, but you do it lovingly.
Well, here's a brave statement. There's only one way to bring up a kid. Now, you're painting yourself in the corner, Leman, by saying that. But see, most of us, grew up in authoritarian homes.
It's true.
Where parents said, hey, you listen up. You go and do what I tell you to do.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, you want something to cry about? I'll give you something to cry about. I mean, how many people identify with that?
Boy, I do.
But today, we have the permissive parents walk 5 steps. You step on one of those suckers, mm-hmm. and they say things like, Brittany, it's 8 p.m. Have you chosen to go to bed yet? So either extreme, Terry, breeds rebellion.
Yeah.
And the question is, again, if you're a person of faith, is God an authoritarian?
Mm-hmm.
Does he take Terry Musin by the scruff of the neck and say, you will do this? No. But his holy word says, every knee shall what?
Bow.
So is God an authoritarian? No. But all of our child rearing is premised on authoritarian mm-hmm. principles. And what St. Paul tried to tell us was, no, you need balance.
And it's relationship, relationship, relationship. It's the love that you have that changes the response, right?
You know, you and I don't hang out with people that we're not comfortable with.
That's true.
And kids, I got news for you, don't hang out with their parents because they feel uncomfortable around their parents all the time. They're mm-hmm. grilling them. They're rule-oriented. They make great Pharisees. Okay? And so I, you know, the title of this book, I had a publisher and I had a little skirmish over this because I wanted to call it Have a Happier Family by Friday. And they said, no, Leman, it's Have a Happy Family by Friday. And they're a bunch of firstborn children. You can't tell them a thing. But they said, look around, fat boy, and you tell me, do you see happy families? I said, very few. Then write the book. Mm-hmm. And I did. It's a good book. If your family isn't hitting on all eight cylinders, this is a good one.
Kevin, is it ever too late to start? I mean, what if you've blown it and you've used the wrong terminology, the wrong attitude, you've used what you were raised with? Is it ever too late to change that?
No, it's never too late. But what's happening today in huge numbers are boomerang children who we praise them for anything they ever did.
Yeah.
We overpraise them. Praise is not good for kids, believe it or not. Praise God. All others pay cash. I wish we had time to develop that thought, but we don't. But we've created this monster, this mm-hmm. kid who can't stand on his own 2 feet. We send him to college, go broke trying to do it, and then the kid can't get a job and comes home and lives with you, and he'll suck you dry.
Yeah.
And I'm convinced there's times you just say, honey, it's time for you to go out and
find the real world for yourself.
Yeah. Bye-bye.
Yeah. Well, there's just such a wealth of wisdom. You know, you can never cover it in a short interview. So I want to advise you to get the book. It's called Have a Happy Family by Friday. And it's got wise counsel in it, no matter where you're at in your parenting journey, available wherever books are sold. Thank you. Always great to have
and
you.
And in every airport.
Yeah. There you go. Can't think of a better place to buy a book than there.